Hey guys, Ravi here, and this is the ESP32 FireBeetle board from dfrobot.com. This is a development board much like an Arduino. That penny sized chip that you see, that's the ESP32 chip. That contains Wi-Fi 802.11, Bluetooth 4.2 and a ton of feature packed I/O. But this video is not about this chip. It's about the board built around it. I have been playing with the FireBeetle board for a few weeks now, and here's my review of it. Open disclaimer, the FireBeetle board and the expansion shield were sent to me by dfrobot.com for free, but the views and opinions presented in this video are my own. Overall, the board is really good as any other Arduino board that I have used over the years. It is noticeably larger than the popular Arduino Nano, but smaller than the Uno. It's solidly built, the white text on the black PCB looks great, the solder joints are clean and the micro USB port doesn't flex. The board came well packaged and with the option of male or female headers, where I did a horrible job of soldering. Speaking of GPIO pins, here are the ones that FireBeetle expands and here are the ones it doesn't expand. Pin 32 and 33, which are supposed to be touch inputs. Hence, out of the 10 capacitive touch inputs of ESP32, only 8 are available, off of which pin 0 and 2 don't work because of some software issue. So, only 6 touch inputs can be used. All the other functions and pins work seamlessly. Speaking of pins, they are only marked on the bottom of the board and not on the top, which gets very annoying at times. In a similar vein of strange unavailability, the official board manager link doesn't work, but the ESP32 Arduino page on GitHub does have the FireBeetle support. Other than these few nitpicks, the board works great. There are no strange driver issues, the code uploads seamlessly every time. It's reliable and pretty easy to tinker with. The battery support is a big plus. It charges the LiPo when plugged into USB. It also has low voltage protection for the battery, so you don't need to worry about that. On the topic of bonuses, I got sent this expansion shield along with the board. It thankfully marks the pins on the top and also gives you way more pins to work with. But more importantly, it works nicely with the DF Robot's Gravity range of products, which is an extensive list of sensors and extensions. In conclusion, aside from a few little annoyances, the board works great. I hope that they release a version 2 of this board with the pins marked on top and a more extensive shield support. But would I recommend it as the microcontroller for your next project? As noted on their website, the support for ESP32 is still under development and the board is recommended only for experienced developers. I hope you liked this video. If you did, make sure to hit that like button. Let me know what you think of the board in the comments below and subscribe for some really interesting projects coming soon.